Hello.
I'm Hushcho, and I'm here today to talk a bit about the difference between free speech and tolerance. These are things that have been confused and conflated by the idiots that tried to overthrow the government over the results of an election that had been decided some months before. Free speech and freedom of expression do not mean that you are protected from the consequences of your actions. If you yell, "Fire!" in a crowded room, people are probably going to panic, people are going to get hurt and might be killed, and you are very much responsible for that if there was not, in fact, a fire. And context is super important. Just yelling fire in the middle of a crowded room of people in general is different than saying, for example, if you were at a weed convention and you said, "Brother, this shit is fire!" Because people at a weed convention will probably know what you're talking about. And the biggest threat you probably have to deal with there is people mobbing the table where you are wanting to buy more of that stuff. It is in this way such a bizarre, surreal, and frustrating thing to deal with, seeing this in the news so much, and seeing these assholes try and parade it around without a context. For example, in that impeachment, in these hearings that they're doing, I want you to remember that most of the Republican Party are a-okay with this shit going down, and they were in the fucking building, cowering in their little bunkers, when this shit was going on. They were there and they knew this happened. And yet they keep bringing up shit like, "Oh, let's play a bunch of clips out of context that have the Democrats saying the word fight in it." Well, see, the thing is, you can use a word, but context is really important. When Trump said, "Go to the Capitol and fight like hell for your democracy," pretty much all of these people that did exactly that got the message from him that they needed to go and literally fight. They had all kinds of armaments, bombs, guns, everything. Even if they barely used them, they were ready for this. And yeah, it's absolutely likely that someone who was ready in the first place, because they're completely out of touch with reality, to fight is going to actually fight. They were just down the street. Plus, it is really, really damning that he didn't notify any authorities. He knew all this was happening. He didn't do anything to oppose it because he knew what he was doing when he said it. He knew what he was doing when he directed those people to do that. And they're so out of touch with reality, they think that they can just take things that we, as minorities, oppressed people, what have you, will often claim in situations usually where it is true. In a lot of situations, our free speech and freedom of expression is oppressed, and it is incredibly important, crucially important, that we defend that. But in this case, they actually did something to have these consequences of being made persona non grata. And it's something that companies like Twitter and Facebook cannot afford to continue being complicit in by their tolerance of this outright intolerance and hate and evil and all of these toxic, harmful things that have caused direct harm to hundreds of thousands, if not millions of people. They are never going to get the stink out, even though they've banned Donald Trump from their platform. They waited too long, and he basically tanked it. And don't delude yourself, Twitter's not on our side. They were never on anybody's side but their own. It's one of the reasons why I left Twitter. I didn't want to be complicit by my silence, because they will silence you in this horrible debacle. There's a difference, too, between censorship and oppression and just the consequences of your actions of being a toxic, horrible person. My many challenges throughout my career, going to all these sites and having them be like, "Oh, we don't do your kind of shit, you know, nudity and sex is wrong no matter what it is," even though it's a huge range of things, and nudity and sex aren't even related. It's the same as if my comic were in Spanish and they said, "We don't like your kind of people, fuck off." Or, "Because my comic is gay," which I fully believe, a couple of places I've gone and have been made unwelcome. That's why. But you know what? That's censorship, and I've fought it all my life, and I probably always will. I didn't do anything to these people. I didn't do anything to deserve that, being silenced and oppressed, but I was still silenced and oppressed. That is what that is. That is why censorship is bad, and that is why free speech and expression must be fought for. However, if I had gone to a place, been made welcome, and decided that I wanted to, let's say, hack the servers and just ruin the site by putting penises everywhere, just dicks everywhere. You can't look anywhere on this site without seeing a dick. That's incredibly selfish of me, probably not very artistic, and it will probably not be received very well. Because, dicks aside, I'm still actively, directly assaulting their host, their server. So they would have every right to make me persona non grata and say I'm forever banned from their site. That's not censorship. That is dealing with the consequences of my actions. And yeah, I'm taking a little bit of delight in the fact that these are the same assholes who pass censoring laws, who try and suppress and oppress the speech and the expression of other cultures, other subcultures especially, and try and homogenize people because they think that only they and their groups and what they value are important and should be allowed. These are the kind of people who are okay with children in cages and concentration camps. Do not forget that. Anyone who is defending Trump, Republican or Democrat, should be removed from office and never allowed to hold public office again. Fascism should not be tolerated. In fact, the more intolerant a group is, the less they should be tolerated. Because ultimately, if you give an intolerant group power enough, they will take away tolerance entirely. They are a danger to tolerance with their intolerance. And I'm not saying that Democrats are blameless, pure creatures. Fuck no. I was very, very critical, and for good reason, during Obama's 8 years of shit. You want to know who I don't like? I don't like Obama. I don't like Hillary Clinton. Because you know what they did? Nothing about police brutality. They didn't care about our rights being violated by the TSA. In fact, they're on record as saying, oh, it's absolutely okay by me. They could have done or said so much more about the horrible things that happened while they were in office, in power, and had influence. They did not. I hold them responsible for that. And I will never trust them or like them. They're Democrats. That doesn't make them good people. But it also doesn't make them the irredeemable dumpster fire that is the Republican Party. I desperately hope that they do have a faction split off. I hope Trump divides them completely, because that will mean that they are never able to take that much power ever again. And I say good. We are at a situation unprecedented in history, and I think we need to do a lot of house cleaning in our own houses, in our own lives. We need to get people out that are delusional enough to be this dangerous, because anyone who is supportive of Trump or his followers, and anyone who will just buy into the Republican lines of bullshit and lies that they are just obviously serving up, is a danger to us, and does not value us or our lives. Any of these people are not okay with us. They are incredibly intolerant, and they would in a second pass a law making people illegal. One of the most execrable things that has happened in the past decade is these same kinds of assholes using the word illegal as a noun, as if people can be illegal. Fuck you. I don't care if you believe life has inherent value or not, but if you are a politician, and you are a leader, and you are influencing policy, and you are influencing law, you don't get to regard anyone as illegal for just existing. Go to hell and get out of my life. So, in summary, free speech and tolerance may be in many ways related, but I especially resent these assholes trying to claim that their free speech or their constitutional rights are being infringed upon when that is not the case. They staged an armed uprising, and now they are finding that they are persona non grata. Let me cry a river for you. People's lives have been destroyed and careers have been ruined for so much less. And a lot of the time, it's nowhere near as bad as what these people did by either, in the interest of following, an insane fascist completely out of touch with reality, as they are out of touch with reality. They would very much like their delusions to be true, but they are not true, and they don't actually understand how to work towards their goals to make them more likely, which I guess we can be grateful for, because they would be a lot more effective if they had a brain inside their heads or had any sort of contact with reality. But it's simply delusional, and that cannot be allowed when the entire legal system and governance of a giant country is at stake. I will fight with my life for freedom of speech and expression. I will fight against censorship until I am gone from this world. But I will not fight for tolerance of people whose actions have marked them as not only enemies to me, but enemies to every living thing on this planet, most especially the people who hold any value for life, theirs or others. We must comport ourselves as adults, mature and grown-ups, which means that we have to think of others as much as we think of ourselves. We cannot assume that any man is an island, and that any man is free from the consideration of those around him. We must all come together to protect our own freedoms from those who would cheapen them by claiming that they are being censored and they are being oppressed, when it is they who are fighting so hard for the oppression and suppression of the same people who are now openly telling them that they are not welcome and that they do not like that kind of evil. Sorry, not sorry, being a giant Nazi, wearing the armband, flying the flag, and goose-stepping doesn't win you a lot of friends, and you have to deal with limited outlets for your hate speech. Wow, it's almost like you're completely out of touch with reality. In any case, I do hope you'll take accounting of your own life and distance yourself from these very dangerous people. They do not care about you or your well-being, and they will do everything they can to keep you from the things that you love, and they will try and destroy those things and people. They have no value for lives that are not part of their group, and they must never be trusted for any length. I'll see you again next time. You're welcome. Bye.